Welcome to the second video on Introduction to Operations Management. In this video, we're going to talk about functions within the organization. In the previous video, we already talked about basic terminology of operations management, including goods and services. So when we talk about any organization, such as a manufacturing firm, university, hospital, hotel, even non-profit organizations such as charities, they consist of different departments. And when we talk about operations management, we focus on three basic functions within the organization. Operations function, that's where goods and services are produced. So for example, for a cafeteria, when you're serving customers, you have direct interaction with customers. So that's an operations function for a cafeteria. So there are the two functions with which operations interact directly. Marketing. So marketing serves as a link between customer and an organization. So marketing allows organizations to collect data from customers in terms of their feedback. This data could be very useful to improve the product or service, as well as to develop new products and services. Within this course, you will understand that the data you're going to collect from customers, it can lead directly to the quality improvement through improving not only product, but also the process that we're using to produce those products or services. The other important function that directly interacts with operations is the finance. In order to run the operations, in simple terms, to manufacture products, services, or goods, we need funds, right? To purchase raw material, to pay labor, to pay the wages, to pay any other cost that's related to operations. So finances, they take care of that. And how are we going to make money? By selling goods and services. So there needs to be a synergy between the various functional areas that exist within an organization so that your operations are effective and efficient. So from here, we will explore operations or manufacturing into a bit more details. But before we go to that, let's look into some of the other functions that exist within an organization. So we already talked about these three basic functions, right? Creating demand, interacting with customer, providing money in order to run your operations, and producing goods and services in the operation, right? However, there are other functional areas such as MIS, Management Information Systems. So you may be using enterprise resource planning, any other computer-based systems within your organization to run the operations. So we need to have an MIS department, either within your organization or outsourced to any other vendor. However, MIS will interact with operations to serve the information needs. Similarly, I need raw material, parts to manufacture goods or services. So I need to have a purchasing department who is going to deal with my suppliers so that we have right raw material at right time, at a right price, and at right quality. The next aspect is human resources. So we need people who can run our machines, who can work for operations. So we may need to do some hiring at some point. If demand goes low, we may be firing some people. We may need to train our people. So all those needs are served by HR, right? Similarly, there are other departments such as logistics to serve the transportation and warehousing needs, product design, bringing new products to the market or enhancing existing products, maintenance. We need to maintain the machines so that those are up and running. So there's going to be a maintenance department which is directly supporting the operations. Manufacturing engineering that will come into play to develop the blueprints or designing the processes so that the processes are efficient and effective. So all these are explained in your textbook in a bit more details on page number 8. I would like you guys to have a look at that, and if you have any questions, please reach me out. But the key idea here is, in order to achieve the organization goals, all these functions must interact. Okay, from here, let's explore operations function area in a bit more details. So as we go through next few slides, we're going to look into some examples. But before we go to those examples, let's clear this terminology. So at the moment, I'm using a generic term, a transformation process or a conversion process. So what is a process? A process represents a series of linked activities. And each process is always going to have certain inputs which are transformed to certain outputs. So there are two more attributes at play in order to make operations effective and efficient. So this is feedback and control. So we collect feedback from operations. That means collecting data from machines, collecting data from customers based on the service we have provided. So we use that feedback or data in order to control our operations. I always use a very simple example. So let's say you want to make a cup of coffee for your partner. So in that case, coffee making process is a transformation process. So this coffee making process is going to have certain inputs such as coffee, sugar, milk. So I have materials. Let's say I have a coffee maker, a machine, labor. I'm making this coffee by myself. Right? Information, you're going to ask your partner that what kind of coffee he or she wants, how much milk, how much sugar. So based on that process, we'll go through set of activities when it comes to transformation. I will boil the water, mix the coffee, mix sugar, add the milk, and serve it to my partner, right? So in this case, a good, which is a cup of coffee, is produced. So now you can collect feedback from your partner. So he or she may say, there's too much sugar, right? So which means there's some deviation from what is being asked by the customer. So then the next thing you can start thinking about how I can control this process, how I can make sure that next time I'm going to have right amount of sugar. So that's what we mean by the control, which means using the data that you collected through feedback in order to improve or enhance the existing process. So there's another term, value added. Value is added whenever you process any material, information, or parts. In this case, I processed coffee, sugar, milk, water, and value is added in terms of cup of coffee being produced. We'll explore this in more details as we go through other chapters, because value, the concept of value will change based on customer perception. Hey, so before we go further, so here's the definition of feedback and control, that what we said. So here's an example of a transformation process that belongs to canned vegetable. So here you can see you have set of activities that you go through in order to have a canned vegetables where you're cleaning, you're making cans, then the vegetables being cut, cooked, packaged, labeled, and you may want to add a few more steps. There may be some quality control steps to ensure that the right quality is produced, right? And at each of these stages, you may have some feedback mechanism where you're collecting data about these processes and using that as a feedback mechanism in order to control the operations, right? So have a look at this example, and similarly you can produce your own example based on your experience at your workplace or based on the course that we are doing here as operations management. So I would pose you a question. Can you think of the transformation process of delivering operations management course? So what would be the inputs? What will be different steps in the transformation process? And what would be the output from a course delivery process? So think about it. And if you have any questions on this, please ask me during our lecture time. So here's an example of a hospital where we are looking into the transformation process by treating some of the patients where they go through a surgery, then they are in a monitoring unit, then they have post-surgery therapy, and so on. So the output is healthy patients, but the essence of the transformation process remains the same. You use the feedback mechanism to collect data from our customers, from various activities, and control these activities in order to enhance the future operations. Now you can think what an example of transformation process for the airline. Because in the previous video, we took the example of an airline in order to explain the service components. So think about various activities that will be involved, let's say, in a departure process. And you can think those activities as a transformation process from the point where a passenger is checked in to the point where the flight is departed. Okay, so based on that you can define the inputs and the output of that process. Again, we can have this as a discussion point when we have face-to-face lesson, so please feel free to ask me questions on this. So I'll stop here with this part of the video, and I will catch you in next video with the remaining concepts of chapter 1. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach me out.